Hello and welcome to Business Reporter's Internet of Things campaign. I'm Alistair Greener. Remember heavy keyrings like this one? Security staff used to carry them to keep hospitals, schools, hotels, the office and other public buildings safe. They were in control of who could access rooms, wards, outbuildings, cupboards and even cabinets. Now, you could be forgiven for assuming that technology has made this job easier. These days, office managers hand out magnetic cards or digital lock codes, which have replaced the security guard's chunky bunch of keys. But imagine a hospital. Patients and visitors roam around freely. Contractors have access to parts of the buildings for weeks. Staff need to have quick and easy access. And medical supplies must be kept secure. Hundreds of people need access to different rooms, wards and levels. So is the administrator's work cut out for them? Or is there a better way to keep doors secure until the moment they need to be opened by an authorised person? Well, this is what we're going to discuss today with Jessica Hawkinson and Marcus Negan from Sony. Good morning.
Good morning.
What is the problem with those old-fashioned keys and the, you know, the existing locks that we use with the cards and everything? What's the problem with all of that today?
Take key cards today, like this one, for instance. If the administrator needs to put access on it, it has to be manually. And the user that is going to use it have to go to somewhere and actually collect that card. If you take a normal key, if that gets lost, that will need to change the hardware, the locks in the building, and that could obviously be very costly. The last thing is with security, you're granted access 24/7, 365 days a year. There's no other way to do it today, and it's all or nothing. Can't be more accurate than that.
Even with the latest technology, with the key cards, as you're implying there, there's a lot of hassle still. There's a lot involved with that. But can we actually measure that loss? Is it tangible?
Oh, yes, it's very tangible. Security breaches cause huge losses, especially in hospital and healthcare. We have reports from US that tell us that hospital experiences around $7,000 to $8,000 in losses in medicine and equipment per bed per year. That was equivalent of £5,000 to £6,000. So it's definitely tangible.
When it comes to hospitals, for an example, and healthcare institutions, what kind of access management problems do they have? Could you maybe give us some examples?
Well, they have, like any large organization, how to keep track of hundreds or even thousands of people coming and going daily. High staff turnover worsens the problem. If an employee leaves and doesn't hand in their key, there's a security risk. One example is medicine cabinets, where hospitals are facing a lot of problems having to manage the access rights to those cabinets. They don't know who has access and who doesn't. So lots of prescription drugs goes missing and ends up on the street.
That is amazing. But what you're suggesting is the fact that we can have convenience and we can have the security. And normally they don't go together. So how can we have it in this case?
Well, from a security aspect, with our solution, you have a much tighter security, but in a more discreet way, and without have to add any security guards or anything like that. And it's a very convenient way of distributing access rights with a pinprick accuracy. Nobody is getting access granted if they don't need it. And we can grant that on a specific place and actually during a particular time.
This is using some of the very latest digital technology. So how has the cloud and IoT helped you with this solution?
Well, foremost, it makes your life a whole lot more simpler. In the past, you have to adapt to technology as a user or administrator. But with IoT, we can actually develop solution suited for the needs and the behavior of people using it in a day-to-day work. For an example, we can send access rights, we can update access rights, and even revoke them over the air on the go.
Now, we've got a sample lock here on the table. Your solution's called Criotive. Can you explain exactly how it works?
So as a business user, you would lock into the web interface and create user groups or lock groups, create a key and send it virtually over the air to a user's mobile phone for card transfer or directly to a connected wearable. You then have instant access to facilities, doors, buildings, medicine cabinets. And as Marcus mentioned, that access could be revoked instantly as well.
That's the theory behind how it all works. Perhaps you could give us some examples of it working actually in practice.
Yeah, well, let's stay with healthcare for a minute and take the plight of district nurses. They usually need to attend several sites each day, and that's a lot of work and time being spent on going back and forth to the admin office, collecting keys and changing keys. So with our solution, we can actually send the key or the access right to the mobile phone, and they can access there directly. That saves you time, it saves fuel costs, and obviously the frustration, not to mention. Another thing is property owners or facility management companies. They might want to have one access system covering several buildings, several cities, maybe even countries. Then they can use our solution on top of the hardware that they already invested in and get that to work.
Construction sites is also a very good example. They have lots of people coming and going daily, and they want to allow access only to registered employees and be able to keep track who's on the premise and who's not. And Criotive can do exactly that. It can limit the access rights at the main gate. It can also restrict your access to containers, which stores tools, of course, and to equipment.
One big assumption here is that, you know, any construction site or hospital meets those minimum requirements of connectivity and infrastructure. But what if they don't?
It's a good question there. As Criotive is a cloud-based solution, we're not really dependent on anything else than connectivity, and that's the network connectivity. So as long as your mobile phone or your device have connectivity to a cellular network or Wi-Fi network, you meet those requirements. So it's really not an issue.
Let's say you've won me over. Let's say I'm somebody who's in charge of the decision-making when it comes to security and locks and so on. How do we get started? What's the process?
Yeah. You contact us through our website, criotive.com, or through our social media channels. Then we set up a meeting, and during that meeting, we'll go over what your needs are and what we're able to support you with, whether it's a small medicine cabinet, which is pretty much plug and play, or whether your business needs are far more complex with multiple access points. Then we will develop an integration plan and execute it together with you.
Now, this integration plan, can it be done, you know, on a small scale to start off with and then built up, or do you have to do everything all in one go?
It can definitely be built up. So you can start with one facility and then you can scale it as you want to. And the good thing about having a software solution like Criotive is that it's no limits to the number of users or the number of access points that you want to add to your management system. It just scales infinitely.
Now, this is using the very latest in digital technology, and it was created in Sweden. Why Sweden?
Right, it's in Lund, in the southern parts of Sweden. And that's where the home base is for our R&D center that develops 4, 5 and 6G and even IoT solution. It's also the base for Sony's largest software development site for mobile, Sony Mobile. Our division, Sony Network Communications Europe, we spearhead the new development of IoT solutions and product, foremost for the European market.
It's an amazing piece of technology, and you've spelled out some incredible advantages that hospitals and other places can use it for. If you had to sum up what we've been talking about, what would the key takeaways be for any person watching this video?
Well, Criotive is a vendor and technology agnostic solution, so we don't tie you up with any specific brands of lock. It is an access management system that gives you pinprick accuracy, and it's future-proof, so you can scale it as far as you want.
So it's been really interesting finding out more about this. So thank you very much indeed for coming in. Jessica Hawkinson and Marcus Negan from Sony, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Thank you.